Hello guys, Emmanuel here. In this video, we're going to see how to use the Substance plugin with Blender and Octane. So let's get started. The Octane version I'm using is the latest one available in the Toys forums, and this version is based on Blender 2.82a. Be sure to download both, the Blender Octane Edition and the Octane Server. As always, before opening Blender for Octane, check that you have the Octane Server running. And then open Blender for Octane. Before setting it up as a renderer, we need to check that it is enabled in the Add-ons section. In my case, it is. So we change the render engine to Octane and select the render in the viewport. Let's change the kernel type to path trace and disable the color management at the bottom. Now it's time to create a substance. Before doing it though, we need to consider that Octane is still a work in progress, so that the update won't work correctly. Hopefully, the devs will be able to fix this soon. So with the live update disabled, we select the substance and set the render to Octane. Then we click Create. If we want to change a parameter and update the material, we have two choices. We can either change the material name or open the Octane node graph and reload the textures by hand each time we modify and bake a parameter. I usually prefer the former because it is faster. So let's do it. As you can see, the material gets updated. Regarding the output channels available, just like with Cycles and Eevee, the Octane preset can handle additional maps if needed, like emissive, height, and opacity. Also, you can create your own presets if you want to use a custom workflow. Well, that's all for now. In the next video, we'll learn how to use a custom workflow with the plugin.
Good luck!